Hello friends, today we will discuss the false position method. It is another approximate method to find the rough or approximate root in the numerical techniques of the numerical maps. So first of all, we will see the geometrical interpretation or the what is the geometrical characteristics of this false position method. Okay, to find the approximate root of any function, let us consider y is equal to fx. Function is given in the problem, then let's see this function is varying from a to b because I have chosen an interval a comma b. Where my root is lying between a to b. Again, fa and fb should be such that fa should be positive and fb should be negative. Okay, so you can see that this curve intersects at the point n. So you know that the intersection of any curve at the x axis is called the root, is called the solution, or that value should satisfy the function because it is intersecting at the point x or at the x axis. So on should be my real root. Because curve is intersecting at the point n. Now in false position method, what you do, you draw the chord, a chord, chord, okay, at the extremities of the interval that you have chosen. Let's suppose my interval is a comma b, then what will the coordinate of this extremities point? x1 comma y1, that is xa, and y is what? It will satisfy the function. So what will be my x1 comma y1? It will be a comma y1. y1 will be fa. Okay, you can put the value of just in the function. So this is the my first coordinate of the extremities, and second coordinate of the extremities is b comma fb. Again, x2 comma y2. x2 is b, and fb is just satisfied the value of b in the function. So this is the coordinate of a and b, extremities of the chord. Okay, you can join the chord also, a to b. Then you will see that chord is intersecting at the point q. Then q will be my better approximate root. So OQ will be my better approximate root. OQ will be better approximate root. Okay, you can also draw the perpendicular from extremities A to M and from any point between Q to B to N. Okay, now you have to find the equation of the chord. What is chord? Chord is a straight line, and you have given the two point extremities point A and B. So what is the equation of a straight line passing through the two point? Equation of a straight line passing through the two point is y minus y1 is equal to mx minus x1, where m is the slope of that straight line or the chord, and y1 and x1 is the point of the A. Okay, what is the m? M is the slope. What will the slope? Slope will be y2 minus y1 upon x2 minus x1. This is the slope. So y minus y1. y1 is fa. Y minus y1 is equal to fb minus fa. y2 minus y1 upon x2 minus x1. B minus a. Multiply x minus a. This is the equation of the chord. Now I know that my better approximate root is OQ, not ON. So at the OQ is what? Q is the intersecting point of the chord at the x axis. So Q will be have the value x comma 0, because at the x axis y vanished to 0, or y has the 0. So y should be 0 here for OQ. Y should be 0. So you can put at the value of y 0. Then you will get minus fa is equal to fb minus fa upon b minus a, multiply x minus a. From here you can get the x. X will be a fb minus b fa upon fb minus fa. This is the x. Now you can see here that this is the x and this is the my better approximate root. Again, you have to do the trials here. It is not my final root. You will do trials and trials. As in the Newton Raphson method, in the last video we have seen, you have to do the trials here. This is the geometrical interpretation. A curve is given, a curve is intersecting at some point n, and I have drawn the chord by choosing some point at the curve at some interval a comma b such that f and fb are positive, and chord is intersecting at some point Q, and for chord Q, the Q is the intersecting point, OQ is my better approximate root. So this is the formula, I can say it's a fault position method, AFB minus BFA upon FB minus FA. Let's suppose this is the cubical polynomial, and we will see that false position method is applicable or not. So x cube plus x minus 1 is equal to 0. Now it is given that x is equal to 1. Why it is given x is equal to 1? It is very important why it is given x is equal to 1. X is equal to 1 is given that it is saying that your better approximate root should be near to 1, not exceeding to 1. So you have to choose your interval, and interval is limited to 1. Your B is limited to 1. A can you choose less than 1. Your B is 1, your A should be less than 1. Okay, and B is 1. Okay, your better approximate root should be less than 1. This is the limit of your interval. So what I have to do, first I will say that what value will come when x is equal to 1 will satisfy. When x is equal to 1 satisfy, here 1 plus 1 minus 1 is equal to plus 1. So I have choose less than 1. I have choose 0.5. At the 0.5 it gives the minus 0.375. So my interval is right. F1 is positive and FB is negative. This interval has been chosen, A and FB. Now what I will do? My interval is from 0.5 to 1. X lies between 0.5 to 1. So my better approximate root in false position method should be come between this. Okay, so my x1 is 0.5 and x2 is 1. Now this is the method. What is method? A and B should be given. So A have 0.5 and B is 1. So I have replaced A and B by x1 and x2. The formula become x1 fx2 minus x2 fx1 upon fx2 minus fx1. So what is x1? x1 is 0.5. What is fx2? fx2 is f1 minus x2. x2 is 1. Multiply f 0.5 divided by fx2 minus fx1. f1 minus f 0.5. So it comes 0.61. It comes 0.61. Now my A will change. Now my A will change and x2 will be fixed, because it is given in the problem that your x2 is fixed, your B is fixed. So now my x2 will be changed. Sorry, my x1 will be changed. Okay, you get here 0.61 when you have choose the interval from 0.5 to 1. Okay, at 0.5 to 1 you get 0.61. You get 0.61. Sorry, 0.64. It is 0.64. You get 0.64. You can see that what is the value at the 0.64. If you put 0.64 here, you will get minus 0.0979. Minus 0.0979. Now you can see that your solution is not going to 0. But it means that your value is not satisfying to the 0 up to the 2 decimal. We will see that it satisfies up to the 2 decimal, up to the 3 decimal. It means that your 0.0979, 0.00979. So I will do some trial also. So I will take A as 0.64 and B as 1 again. B is fixed here. So again my x1 will be 0.64 and x2 will be 1. 0.641. Again I will use this formula. Then I will get 0.672. Okay, we will see at what value come at 0.672. If I put 0.672 in given function, then I will get 0.0245. It is again not giving the better approximate value near to 0, or it is not my final root. So I will do again trial. I will choose this as x1 and x2 is fixed 1. So my better approximate should be lie between 0.672 to 1. x1 will be 0.672 and x2 will be 1. So again I will apply 0.672 f1 minus 1 into 0.672 divided by f1 minus 0.672. Here I get 0.6822. 0.6822. So when I put 0.6822 in given function x2 plus x minus 1, then I get 0.00030627.85. You can see that this value is coming nearly to 0, up to the 2 to 3 decimal. So this can be your better approximate root. I am not saying that you can not do further trials. You can do further trials. You can choose again this as a X1 and X2 is one fix, you can do trials and trials and you will get more less value, more less negative value you will get. This time you can get 0.0002, 0.0625. Then if you do more trials, then you can get 0.0010, 6275, or you can get 0.000. So this is the again trial method, repeated approximation method. Here is the formula. You can do trials and trials. You should have some interval. Interval is very important in this false position method. Okay, your interval, in interval your B and A should be such that it give the opposite sign value, and you can choose the interval between that, as I have choose the interval 0.521. Then I am changing the interval, or I am changing the extremities of the chord, you can say that. I am changing the extremities of the chord. So that if this is the OQ, then second time my Q can be shifted here Q does. When I will do my trials, as 0.5 is replaced by 0.64, okay, then Q is shifted to Q dash, then again Q dash is shifted to Q double dash, Q triple dash, as the value comes near to 0, okay, because your final pattern approximation root should be satisfy the function near to 0, okay, you will not get the final solution, you have to do the trials. So this is the false position method. You have to remember that this is the formula AFB minus BFA upon FB minus FA. This comes from the equation of the chord, and at the equation of the chord you put the value y is equal to 0 to find the OQ intersection of the chord at the x axis. So friends, today we have discussed the false position method. It is the trial method as we have discussed in the Newton-Raphson method. In the next video, we will discuss about some more approximate and more methods in the numerical techniques of maths to find the solution or root of an equation or the function. Okay?